What's up, everyone? Welcome to Triple X Church. I am Aaron R. Gillespie the First. Yeah. Given the nature of this site, and just given my heart, I believe that people, one of the first steps and one of the key steps to healing is honesty. And people, a lot of times, especially when it comes to porn, sex, all of the above, people don't really want to be honest about that. You know what I mean? For me, I got shown my first porn magazine at 6 in my cousin's treehouse. And it's funny because I'm 28 today, and I haven't really had a porn struggle since like high school, but I still remember being 6 years old and seeing that, you know what I mean? I still remember those images, and that's weird, right? Like that many years, but for me, more of my struggle, is mental, you know what I mean? I think once you allow a little bit of something to happen, a little bit of a website to slip, or a little bit of a night out with a girlfriend gone too far, stuff, it just gets stuck in your brain. I think people don't really realize how the God of this world has designed that stuff to work. You know, I think that if you read the Bible constantly, it talks about sexual sin and how it's like the worst sin. You know, how like it'll eat at you. And I've definitely seen that in my own life, you know. Things stick with you. I'm 28, I'm going to be a father, I'm happily married. I've got people all around me keep me accountable. I still remember things that I saw, you know, 18 years ago. I'm sick of this monster, you gotta get here, you gotta get here. I'm sick of this monster. I think one of the keys to staying accountable, as I've seen before, is honesty. I think people are afraid to be honest. You know, I have men around me on tour. Once you get married, I think that's a totally different subject. But once you get married, right after we got married, Jamie and I, it was a big deal for us to just be totally honest with each other about everything. And at times it was like squirmy and uncomfortable because you know, I feel like God really kind of brought all this stuff to the surface from our past and stuff that I was like, oh, I don't want to talk about this, but I did. And I think that brings healing. I think honesty brings healing. I think God calls us to purity, and I think part of purity is being transparent. So I would say that's the key with accountability, is having the guts to be transparent. We pray with people every night. That's what we do. That's what we're out here ultimately for, that. I think you're anointed by God to do something. You were anointed by Him to do it for Him, not for your own personal gain. So we've really worked hard and been very intentional about kind of making the floor open to people. And I think that hopefully, prayerfully, they're beginning to see that way. You are God. I think pornography affects people in different ways, but it ultimately ends in a destructive way. And that goes without saying. Something that I think about every time I think about pornography is and this subject is the person modeling or acting or having sex on film for money. That person, like, my heart really goes out to that person. You know, that doesn't get talked about a lot. It's always like, oh, I have a pornography addiction and I need help with it, which is it's viable, right? Like, absolutely, it's an awful addiction. I think it's cracking, horrible, breaking. And it's adulterous ultimately, but I think that the women and the folks who are involved in that is what really gets me. I think that as men and as men of God, we're called to be prophet, priest, and king in our home, and I think that we need to protect our children and we need to protect our loved ones, but we also need to lend a hand in whatever way that you can. You know, but for me, I don't know anyone personally who was ever omitted to me that they were really wrapped up with pornography. I the only thing I can say is, like, you have to really just be on the surface about it. Like, I'm so careful about it. If I see anything, even if it's like just some dumb movie, and I see any kind of nudity, anything, I'll just hit pick up a phone and text someone, say I just saw this today. Like, and that may sound really trite and stupid and kind of extreme, but I believe that, that Jesus calls us to be the church without spot or wrinkle, and I think that takes some work. Today, if you have a porn problem, if you have a premarital sex problem, that's something I dealt with, or any sort of sexual sin problem, my advice, the first thing you should do before anything is tell somebody, which is the last thing that you want to do. It's the last thing that your flesh dude, your body dude wants to do. You don't want to tell anybody. You want to do your dirt behind closed doors and then cover it up like a dog. You know what I mean? Like, that's just how we roll as humans. But God calls us to purity and to life and to truth. And you'll really see that maybe at first, right, you're going to be like, this is really scary. This is going to suck. Everyone's going to judge me. But you'll really see that you'll come out into the light. You know what I mean? Like, you can't. Like, darkness can't hide from light. You know what I mean? Like, you light a match or a lighter in a dark room and lights up the whole room. You know what I mean? Like, if you want that for your life, you have to start with that spark. I believe that every man, every woman, God has a plan for them in a future. And I think that in order to grab onto that future, in order to be part of that future, in order to have that future that God talks about in Jeremiah 29, I mean, you have to say yes to it. Saying yes begins with being honest. Good God, can you still get us home?